Hey guys, and welcome and or welcome back to my channel. So I am back with another foundation hunt, and for about the last 2 months on every single video I have posted, someone has said, can you do a foundation hunt on the Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation? So that is what I am here to do today. However, it's a little different because I've never actually tried a foundation before I filmed the foundation hunt video for it. But if you follow me on my other social media accounts, especially Snapchat, then you know I took over Wet n Wild's Snapchat about a week ago, and so I have tried the foundation already. But you know what? I'm gonna go through as if I haven't tried it, save any opinions I've already formed until the end of the video, and it's also gonna be a little different because I have more than one shade to show you. But before I ramble any further, let's just get into this. So this is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. This retails for $5.99 for 1 fluid ounce and comes in 20 shades. I have 5 shades to show you. The one in my hand is Mahogany, the darkest shade, and I also have Espresso, Mocha, Cocoa, and the last one I believe is called Toffee. Yes, Toffee. So these are the 5 shades on my face. Now, I felt like Toffee was my shade during the takeover. No one agreed with me, so I ended up using Espresso during the takeover. For this video, I'm gonna use Espresso on this side of my face, and then I'm gonna use Mahogany on this side of my face. So basically I'll be using the 2 deepest shades that this foundation comes in on one side of my face. I'm going to set the Mahogany side with powder and then, you know, leave this like I usually do, and then come back later on in the day and we'll see how this holds up. Now, I'm assuming Wet n Wild has watched a couple of the review videos on it, so something they were sure to point out to me is that a lot of people, I guess, complain that the shades are too light, so they were sure to let me know that the shades do oxidize to a darker color throughout the day. And now for Mahogany. Okay, so this is what my face looks like with one side not set and the other side set. Once again, this is Espresso, this is Mahogany, this is the side that is set. I realized while I was doing my face that I didn't let you guys know what this foundation claims to do, and it's like, come on, Shanine, you've been doing this for a year, you should know how it goes. So very quickly, I will let you know that the Photo Focus Foundation claims to flawless camera-ready makeup every time, specially made with a matte, light diffusing complex to give your skin no filter perfection, high-performing breakthrough formula, featuring light adjusting complex to help prevent white cast in photos, tested under 7 light conditions with and without the use of flash. That's all it claims to do. I will do a flash test and remember to insert it later on. And yeah, that is pretty, oh wait, one more thing that I wanna mention. Something different about this foundation is that it has a spatula attached to it. Like, that makes it a whole lot easier getting product out. Just thought I would throw that out there. So it is 9:20, way too early, at least too early for me to function. It's 9:20, so I will be back later in the day to show you how it wore throughout the day and my final thoughts. See, I told you it was too early for me to function. I'll be back later. Okay, so I am back and it is now 7:21. What time did I leave? Like 9 a.m.? It's been a while. It's been 9 hours, I think. Okay, so getting into what this foundation claimed to do, it really doesn't claim to do much. It seems like this foundation's main focus is lighting. You know, they were sure to let you know there's no flashback, you know, photo focus foundation. They were sure to let you know it's been tested in 7 different lighting setups. Tested under 7 light conditions with top smartphone models. Clear blue sunlit sky, outdoor PM, indoor PM, electronic flash, fluorescent light, bathroom light, and nightclub light. So I figured instead of just adding the flash test, which I, when I remember to usually do, I would try out as many light systems that I had available to me. You know, obviously nightclub light, it's a little much for this type of video, so I don't have that. Clear blue sunlight sky. The weather's been pretty crappy here in New York, so I didn't have, you know, blue sky. I had sad gray. So now I'll just insert the different lighting that I did have available to me so you can see how it looks. You know, I feel across the board under the different lighting, it was okay. Like I said, they didn't really claim to do anything else. I think they said that it was a matte foundation. Let's see here. Yeah, other than that, they just said matte, light diffusing complex to give your skin a no filter perfection. It is matte. I will give it that. It does have a matte finish. As far as coverage goes, I would have to say that this is a medium coverage foundation, but it is buildable. I usually only do one layer when I'm doing my foundation hunts, just to see, like, can I put more layers on top of this? And in real life, when I'm doing makeup, I only use one layer anyway. But this is definitely a buildable foundation. You can apply more layers before you start getting cakey, you know, just don't go overboard unless you want to, you know, do you. What else? It has not separated. It did not cling to any of the dry patches that I have. It does transfer though. I should point that out. Now, it was probably noticeable as soon as I came back that the side that I did not set is hanging on for dear life at this point. The oil started showing rather quickly. I think people even noticed that in my takeover because I couldn't use a setting powder in there, that I got oily rather quickly. But the side that I did set, you know, it's been quite a while, and you know, you normally would set your foundation. It's holding up pretty well. You know, I did set this side. Once again, this is the Espresso side. This is Mahogany. Speaking of shades, I did mention before that this foundation oxidizes. You know, I'm not talking Britney Spears to Beyonce type oxidized, but it does get darker. With that being said, I'm not sure which shade I would have to go for, like if I had to pick one. I'm leaning more towards Espresso because I just feel like Mahogany oxidized a little too dark of a color for me to work with. But then the next second I'm like, maybe Mahogany does work. So I don't know. Maybe I should mix them both. I don't know. Let me know in the comments down below which shade you feel is my shade in this foundation. As you can see, you know, there's a little bit of that orange undertone going on with this foundation. However, do I feel it is a workable orange? I would say it's a workable orange depending on what other products you use, you know, cool tone, whatever else type products that you use. I do feel you can work with this foundation. So with all of that being said, let me just get this out of the way now. This will be the last time you see me wearing this foundation. You know, I am very grateful for, you know, Wet n Wild allowing me to try this foundation in different shades at that. But yeah, every single time I've tried this foundation, I've broken out on my face. You know, I tried it before I did the takeover and I broke out. You know, this has been on my face ever since. It's going on more than a week now. And like these two popped up when I tried it before the takeover. Okay, you know. I tried it again when I did the takeover and I broke out here and a little bit here on top of my forehead. I was like, I'm noticing a pattern here. And I will update you in the comments down below if I break out once again from trying it right now. I was looking to see anywhere that said oil free and I didn't see anything that said this foundation's oil free. So I'm thinking that is what it is. Anytime I use some type of, you know, oil serum type skincare or whatever, even if it's in a foundation, I break out. So I'm assuming that's what it is. But I just break out every single time I try this foundation. So that's the deal breaker here for me. But other than that, I like how this wore throughout the day. You know, it has a nice finish. It's got that matte finish and I have combo oily skin. It's long wearing. Once I set it, you know, my oil didn't show through as quickly and as much. So I did like how it wore. But I just can't get past. You know, your girl ain't trying to break out every time she wears foundation, so that's why I'm gonna have to pass on this one. But you know, if you're not acne prone, if you don't have the same type of skin issues that I'm telling you that I have, then it is something that you should check out. If you can find a shade, you might have to mix a shade or two to get your true shade. But you know, this, once again, this does retail for $6, so if anything, if you have to buy two, it'll cost you $12, so that's the worst it'll get. And that is pretty much it for this foundation hunt. You know, I hope seeing the foundation and hearing my thoughts has helped in your decision whether or not you're going to try it out for yourself. Make sure to thumbs up, comment, and subscribe down below. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!